Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up expenses in QuickBooks. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. Setting up expenses is important because it allows you to customize how you will track your expenses and manage bills through accounts payable in QuickBooks Online. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing to demonstrate some concepts. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. To begin, after you sign into your QuickBooks Online account, click on the gear icon and select Account and Settings. Go ahead and click on the Expenses tab. And the first section that we'll edit is Bills and Expenses. To edit this information, click on the pencil icon located to the far right. The Show Items table on Expense and Purchase Forms feature adds a product or service table on expense and purchase forms so you can itemize products and services that you have purchased. For example, Paul likes details. He's going to activate this feature because he wants to be able to easily see the details of what he has spent his money on when he looks at his checks and purchase orders in QuickBooks. If you purchase an item on behalf of a customer and you want to link this item to that customer, then the Track Expenses and Items by Customer feature will add a customer column on expense and purchase forms. While Paul typically bills his customers a rate that will include any materials and parts he uses for the job, there are occasions when his customers make special requests. For example, a customer may want a specific brand for their kitchen sink. Paul will purchase the item on behalf of the customer and bill them back for the cost of the sink. This feature works well for these types of situations. The Make Expenses and Items Billable feature will add a billable column on expense and purchase forms, so you can add billable expenses and items on sales forms to charge customers for items purchased on their behalf. This feature complements the Track Expenses and Items by Customer feature. It will add a column next to the customer column so that Paul can place a check mark in it to mark it as a billable item. QuickBooks will keep track of all billable items, and when Paul is ready to create an invoice for a customer who has billable items, QuickBooks will provide him with an alert that he has billable items to add to the invoice. The default markup rate feature is only available if you have turned on the Make Expenses and Items Billable feature that we just discussed. It allows you to set a default markup rate for items you plan to bill your customers for. In general, Paul prices his services such that he does not need to mark up items that he bills back to his customers. However, there are occasions when he has to go out of his way for specialty items that customers might ask for. In those cases, having the ability to mark up items is helpful. So he will go ahead and set a default markup rate of 30% here. The Track Billable Expenses and Items Income feature is only available if you have turned on the Make Expenses and Items Billable feature previously discussed. You can choose to track this income in a single account or multiple accounts. Click this link to watch our video tutorial on how to set up the chart of accounts to learn how to create a new account. Since Paul does mark up specialty items, he will go ahead and select the Track Billable Expenses and Items as income in a single account. The next feature is Charge Sales Tax. Charge sales tax should be activated if you need to charge your customer's sales tax. The default payment terms feature allows you to set default payment terms for all bills that you enter into QuickBooks. If the payment terms vary by vendor, you can adjust them in the vendor profile when you set up your vendors in QuickBooks. By setting up payment terms in QuickBooks, you will receive reminders when a bill is coming due. Paul has established a great rapport with all of his suppliers. So as a result, he's got 30-day terms with his suppliers, so he'll go ahead and set net 30 as his default here. Let's go ahead and save our changes. Purchase orders. If you need to send purchase orders to your suppliers, you can activate the purchase order feature here. We'll go ahead and activate that. When you activate purchase orders, you have the option to create custom fields. You also have the option to set up a default message that will also be sent to your customers when you email them your purchase orders. Let's go ahead and save our changes. That wraps up the section on setting up expenses. To access this course or any of the others in the series, just click this link. For a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online, click the links below this video. If you have feedback about this course, or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.